very easy, quick, no hassle or hassle-free. So what we have here, we have some garlic and ginger. I have a very small piece of onion that I've chopped, green pepper, tablespoon of chili powder, teaspoon of tomato paste, tablespoon of coriander seeds and 2 cardamom seeds. And this is the star of the meal. I don't feel like just heating it up with some vegetables, so I thought let me just zhuzh it up a bit, and that's why I'm making this meal. And then I also have my new favorite, which is my frozen mushrooms. Great option. Some cheese. I've got a quarter piece of feta cheese, and then I've also got some provolone cheese as well. So I'm very excited. I can't wait to start, and let's get cooking. I have my pan in the stove preheating with a tablespoon of olive oil. So let's get cooking. Let's get started. Cool. Oh, I'm adding the onions. And that's going to saute for about 3 to 5 minutes. I want it to be nice and brown. Okay, and then we'll add the green peppers and the ginger and the garlic paste. So now that we have a slight color to the onions, or the onions are slightly brown, I'm going to add my green pepper and my garlic and ginger paste. So I'm just going to let this saute for about a minute. Just to let the green pepper soften slightly. So the green pepper has softened slightly, and I'm going to add my garlic and ginger paste. And then we're going to let that simmer for a while before we add the rest of our spices. Having onions, green pepper, and our garlic and ginger paste simmering away, and that is going to saute for about another minute or so. And then I'm going to add my tomato paste. I forgot about my tomato paste. Then I'll add my tomato paste before I add the spices, just to cook the tomato paste a bit. And then I'm going to add the spices. And then after the spices, I'm going to immediately add my mushrooms frozen. Add the tomato paste, and we're going to let that just cook for a while. Let's say about another minute or so. And then we can add the rest of our ingredients. Beautiful. So let's just stir that around and let that saute for a while. So let's just give it a nice stir, and let's just make sure that everybody is playing along nicely. So let's just let the spices cook for another minute or two, and then we can add the rest of our ingredients. So now that everything has simmered for, or sauteed for about 2 to 3 minutes actually, I'm going to add my chili powder. Now, I like my meals pretty spicy, so it's really up to you how spicy you want your meal to be. But I like my meals to be spicy, so I've added a tablespoon and a half, of the chili spice that I've got here. So I like it to be really spicy, but you can do it according to your palate. If you want it to be less, you just put in less. If you want it to be more, you can put in more. You can also do fresh chilies as well, but I don't have any more, so I'm using the powder. So here we go. And then just mix everything around and let it saute, and then let that sort of bloom for about 2 to 3 minutes. So it might not look like much now, but it is coming together well. So we're just cooking the chili spice, because remember, spices are raw, so you have to give it some time to cook the actual spices. So about a minute or two, then it should be good. Or when the oil starts to separate from the spice, then you know you're good to go. You can start adding whatever else you need to add to your dish. So I think I'm going to let this go for a few more seconds before I add anything else. But thus far, it's looking good, and I'm really getting hungry now.
A few moments later.
It's had quite a bit of time, and then as you can see, the oil is separated. Everything is cooking nicely. I'm going to add my frozen mushrooms to the mix. Oh, you see that? That is gold, baby. So let's just stir everything together. I'm going to add just a little bit of water, not too much. Remember, the mushrooms are frozen, so they will be releasing water as well. That's looking good, baby. That's coming along nicely. It's looking good. But I think I'm going to add a little bit more vegetables just to bulk up the meal a little bit more. So let me get some of my frozen green beans and add that to it. So I've added about a cup of frozen green beans, and I'm just going to let that thaw in the pan and sort of saute with everything else and get flavored. And then at the end, I'll add the steak. Remember, the steak is already cooked. It's leftover steak from a braai, from a grill, from a barbecue, from a day or two ago. And you don't just want to heat it up and then add a salad on it. So let's just mix everything together. This is going to be so good. Okay. So let the vegetables cook for a while, and then we can add the steak, like I said. So another option is that a lot of people don't like whole spices. Definitely use the spices, the actual spices, and just ground it up, or the ground spice, and then just add that in place of the whole spices. It should be perfectly fine as well. So I'm just going to let this saute for a little while. I'm going to turn the heat up a bit. At the moment, I have it on a medium heat. So let me turn it up and let this gravy start, and let's get this meal sorted.
1 eternity later.
Okay, so everything is coming together nicely, and I just love that sound. Music to my ears. So most of the water has cooked out, veggies are thawed, and I think we're ready to add the steak. And then we're going to add a little bit of salt and some seasoning, obviously to your taste. And don't forget to taste your food and season as you go along. I'm going to wait to season the night at the end, because the steak has got seasoning as well. So let me first add the steak, and then I'll add a little bit of salt, and then we let it cook through, add our cheese, and then let's see what happens. So remember now, the steak is cooked, so all we're basically doing is heating the steak. So I'm going to just do this for about, I'll say 3 to 5 minutes, adding the cheese, darling, the cheese. So we're almost at the end. I'm going to add a little bit of salt, not too much. Remember, to your taste, okay? How salty you like it, or no salt, whatever you're brewing. So I've added the seasoning. I'm going to let this simmer for a little while. Turn down the heat back to medium. Add the cheese, and then I'm ready to chow. So now I'm going to add the cheese, the Tbsp Chilli. Down. You can switch off the stove, clamp the lid on for about a minute or two, just for the cheese to melt. Okay, it has melted, all ready to dish up. So my cheese is melted, and I'm ready to plate. That delicious. One more thing I need to do is add my final crowning of feta cheese, darling. Yeah. And that's masala, steak, cheese, melt. Try it, let me know what you think. It was quick and easy. I think it took me about 20 minutes in total to cook the meal. So I've crumbed over my feta cheese, all ready to eat. I can't wait to dig in. Look at that. Beautiful. Let's go, baby.